Melchizedek, priest and king. Melchizedek was a priest of God and at the same time king of Salem, peace. Abraham acknowledged him and paid him tithes. God prophetically declared through the psalmist that Messiah would be a priest of the Melchizedek order forever. The Jews overlooked this prophecy and thought that everything of a priestly character in connection with God's plan would be fulfilled through the Aaronic priesthood, which was merely typical. Their expectancy of the Messianic kingdom and glory blinded them to his work as a sin-atoning priest. They saw not that Messiah is to be one of many members. Jesus is the head and the elect church the body of the Melchizedek priest. Christians are deeply interested in the Messianic reign, also in the fact that to become members of that royal priesthood means a participation with Jesus in the sacrifice of earthly life, as St. Paul exhorts. The declaration that Melchizedek was without father or mother, without beginning of days or end of years, has puzzled Bible students until recently. The interpretation is now quite satisfactory and simple. Melchizedek was without father or mother in the priesthood. He did not inherit this priesthood. He was without beginning of days and years in respect to his office, in that no record was made when his priesthood began, nor any provision made for a successor. In these respects, he typified Messiah. Melchizedek is supposed to have been one of the shepherd kings who invaded Egypt and built the Great Pyramid, covering 12 acres, known for ages as one of the seven wonders of the world, about 2170 B.C. Astronomers tell that its measurements indicate the length of the year, the weight of the earth, the distance to the sun, etc. Its interior passages represent human history. Downward, the course of sin and death. Upward, the law age, the gospel age, the kingdom glory of the church, and human restitution.